Cancer is a disease of the genome. And in acute myeloid leukemia, there are numerous different mutation classes that give rise to the cancer. So there are structural variants like translocations, there are copy number alterations, there are gains and losses of specific chromosomes, then there are gene level mutations. And if you look at how leukemia or AML is worked up now in the clinical laboratory, we use a variety of different methodologies. We use cytogenetics, which involves directly examining chromosomes under the microscope. Some labs use DNA microarrays. We use PCR-based testing. And so what we found is that whole genome sequencing is really the only assay out there that captures all these different mutation classes. It's also a very simple assay to implement in the clinical laboratory. We can turn it around in approximately 3 days. We find it to be a very useful clinical assay. It's very practical. In our study in New England Journal a couple years ago, we found that over 20% of patients had new mutations that were not identified by conventional testing that we could detect using whole genome sequencing. And we found that 17% of AML patients, these findings actually changed risk criteria. And so risk stratification plays a major role in the treatment of acute leukemia. And so accurate risk stratification is important, and that allows us to develop a treatment plan for each patient that's tailored to their risk of their disease. Minimal residual disease testing, or MRD testing, in leukemia has been part of therapy for the last 10 years. Typically, we generate this data by flow cytometry, which is looking at cell surface protein expression. And the difficulty with flow cytometry-based MRD is that not necessarily every patient has a phenotype that's amenable to flow cytometry testing. What we found by sequencing is that we can identify minimal residual disease, or MRD, in a greater number of patients. It's also a more simplified method for detecting MRD. And it's a very simple approach. And so what we do is we'll sequence patients at diagnosis, and we identify DNA-level mutations in their leukemia. And then the patients receive treatment, and we sequence another sample. It could be a blood sample, it could be a bone marrow sample, and we see if we can identify those same mutations. And if we can identify those mutations, it means the patient hasn't cleared their disease. And that allows us to adjust treatment protocols appropriately. And we've also found that the detection of MRD usually precedes clinical relapse. And so we found that on average there's about 60 days between when a patient's MRD positive and when they've clinically relapsed. And that creates a therapeutic window in which we could intervene and hopefully keep patients from clinically relapsing.